This week's click will fly by, I promise you, if you're on one of the electric bikes that we'll be wheeling out. And with the Tour de France now in full swing, we thought it was high time we showed you this. It looks like an ordinary bike. It is a little bit heavier than an ordinary bike, and that's because it's a prototype of a new e-bike, an electric bike, which goes by the grand name of the Van Moof 10 Electrified. If you've ever ridden an e-bike before, the first thing you'll notice about this one is that it doesn't have that unsightly battery pack sat just below the saddle. That's because the power cells here are built into the frame itself. It takes about 3 hours to charge fully, and it can give you between 19 and 37 miles of range, depending on terrain, traffic, weather, and how you're cycling. Now, this is a so-called pedelec. The electric motor only works when you pedal, so you do have to do some work. But as soon as you do, the power kicks in, helping you whiz up hills and whistle along the flat at a top speed of 18 miles an hour. Although you can cycle at quite a pace, I have to say you notice the electrical assistance most when you're pedaling slowly or up a hill, because the motor kicks in and it's actually difficult to cycle slowly. I mean, there's really almost no effort on my part at all to go at this speed. It's fast. That's why there's a button to switch down from 100% power to 50%. Although, to be honest, I still had trouble keeping it slow, and there's no way of actually switching it off from the control panel. There is a button for the LED lights built into the frame, and even a remote control. The bike won't work without it, so it kind of acts like a theft-deterring immobiliser. The dawn of the electric bike has certainly come and gone before, but as long as you have $3,000 to spare, this one could be here to stay. Now, cycling is becoming increasingly popular in town, and because of that, many cities now have a community bike scheme where you can hire special bikes from docking stations using your credit card and then return them to a different docking station later on where your card is charged. Now, it's usually the docking stations themselves that are the brains of the operation. But in Copenhagen, in Denmark, the community bikes have become smart. Lara Lewington took a ride.
Copenhagen, one of the cycling capitals of the world. A place where there are as many bikes as there are inhabitants. In the 90s, this was the first capital city to install a cycle hire system. So it's little surprise that they've just upgraded to one at the cutting edge. When it comes to hiring a bike, it needs to offer something extra. Now, not only are these electric, but they also come complete with their own built-in, apparently vandal-proof tablet. And when it comes to reserving, booking and paying for one, you can do it all on this. You can select manual or whatever level of pedal power assistance you desire.
You could go for longer distances. It's not sweating. Even if you have your own bike, a manual bike, and you want to go 5 kilometers, the fastest and easiest way to go is on an e-bike, and you get there without sweating.
I'm not that confident on a bike. I was actually quite relieved that even when the electric element kicks in, it still feels comfortable and stable and safe. And the thing is, it's very easy to stop. The tablet offers GPS travel guides enhanced for cycling, making the bikes a liberating way for tourists to explore the city or for commuters to get to unfamiliar locations. There's an option to check train times, and you can even book a bike for someone else, pre-setting a meeting destination to make sure they head to the right place. At the same time, the GPS tracks who is going where, when, and that data is sent home every 10 seconds, meaning information on battery life, location, and usage is constantly being collected. It is, of course, early days now, but the open platform means the potential for software development is huge. One idea they're trying out at the moment is location-based marketing, but there's also scope for improving the cycling experience for the whole city.
We will get a lot of data from the bikes. We're already getting that. What is the average length of a trip? What is the speed people are cycling with, etc.? Because then we can adjust the traffic signals to the speed of the bikes in the morning. If you have a headwind, then maybe they change in another rhythm than if you have the wind in the back.
Is looking down at a tablet when on a bike safe, though? Well, apparently there's been no problem yet.
If you've finished your journey and there's no room in the docking station, then you can actually just leave the bike in a designated safe zone. You put the stand on, lock it, and you can leave. But right now, I'm in luck.
250 of the bikes have been up and running for a couple of months now, but the hope is it'll soon become thousands. Then maybe other cities will follow Copenhagen's example once again.